through who? Through Christ, which strengthens me. And when you come to the Lord and you have that Christ living, that fullness of his life in you, that victory will be yours in Jesus' name. I can do. I can do. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. In Ephesians chapter 3, Ephesians chapter 3, what do you need from verse 17? I will maintain the victory. I will have the triumphant life, the power, the source of that strength, the power that makes us standing against temptation, against sin, and against evil. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 17. That Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith. That's the secret. That Christ may dwell, abide, remain in your hearts by faith. That she, being rooted and grounded in love, may be able to comprehend with all saints what is the breadth and length and depth and height, and to know the love of Christ which passes knowledge, that ye might be filled with all the fullness of God. As you look at brothers and sisters, look up here, have you sometimes wondered about our prayer requests? Sometimes I've wondered, when I hear people pray, and when I see the prayer requests we raise, and when people come to me, Pastor, I want you to pray for me. I say, what's the challenge? What's the problem? This, this, and this. And the prayer sometimes, or maybe many times, they're so low if you compare to the New Testament. And you see the prayers they prayed in the New Testament. Here Paul the Apostle was praying for the church in Ephesus. And this is the kind of prayer he wants us to pray, to understand. We lift up a request, upgrade it, that Christ will dwell in our hearts by faith, and that we will know the length and the breadth and the depth and the height of the love of God, which passes all understanding. Not only that, until we are filled with the fullness of God. What a prayer, what a request. And when we are filled with the fullness of God, all the things that have been overcoming us, and we have been falling and rising, everything will come to an end, and the victorious life will become permanent in our lives in Jesus' name. To be filled with all the fullness of God. And then it says in verse 20, now unto him that is what? Able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh where? Worketh in us. That's the point. When that power worketh in us, when it works in us, we'll not be falling into sin and, you know, rising up every time. You know, somebody's saying, you know, Pastor, I'm still struggling. I said, oh, what's the struggle? It's that thing I told you the other time. What did you tell me the other time? You remember now, Pastor? The way you talk, you don't seem like somebody who forgets something so quickly. I said, remind me, what is it? Is that adultery again? When the power of God is working in you, and you really have mind to live the victorious life, you're not becoming and say, I've gone into it again, I've gone into it again. This time, it will stop. We ought to enjoy the victory of the Christian life. If we don't have the victory over all these sins we've been doing in the past, all our worship is in vain. Because you see, if we're going to be allowed to get to glory, to get to heaven, this victory over sin must be constant and permanent by the power of God in our lives. And I pray it will be. I said it will be. When you have the mind to accept the truth and the word of God, and you know this is the victory, this is the triumph, and the foundation is laid, and the power is working within us now unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us, unto him be glory. in the church by Christ Jesus throughout all ages, world without end. And everybody said, amen. First Corinthians chapter, I told you I'm going to go from Genesis Revolution. Have I even read Revolution today? I'll get there. Praise the Lord. We're looking at 1 Corinthians chapter 15. 1 Corinthians chapter 15. And we're looking at verse 57. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 57. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through who? Our Lord Jesus Christ. Number one, we've seen the scriptural perception. Number two, we've learned about the spiritual power. Now number three, the sure preservation of the triumphant life. After the Lord has graciously given us that triumphant, victorious life, we need to preserve it. And we need to live in that victory day after day and week after week and month after month and year after year. Preservation of that triumphant life in Christ. In 2 Peter chapter 2 verse 1. 2 Peter chapter 2 verse 1. Wherefore the rather, brethren, give diligence to make your calling an election sure. You know, we need to do something. We cannot just allow. It's not going to happen automatically without doing anything, without being diligent about it, without endeavoring to keep what we have. It says, rather, we give diligence to make our calling and election sure. For if ye do these things, ye shall never fall. That's preservation. If you do these things, all the things we've been learning, and all the things we have in the previous verses to this verse 10, if you do that, adding faith and knowledge and virtue and temperance and patience and godliness and brotherly kindness and charity, if you do all that, it says, you shall never fall. I pray will not fall. In Hebrews chapter 3, I'm reading from verse 12. Hebrews chapter 3, verse 12. Take heed, brethren, lest there be in any of you an evil heart of departing, of unbelief in departing from the living God. It says, we need to do that. You take heed unto yourself. After the Lord has saved you, after the Lord has graciously empowered, energized, enabled you, you're not just living a careless life and say, it doesn't matter, I'm a Christian now. Take heed, he says, lest there be in any of you an evil heart of unbelief in departing from the living God, but exhort one another daily while it is called today, lest any of you should be hardened through the deceitfulness of sin. Do you know there's a possibility like that, to be hardened, to go into sin and to go into it again and then again, until you say, it doesn't really matter, I can do anything, it's all of grace and I'll be all right at the end, and you become hardened because of the deceitfulness of sin. It says, take heed so that that does not happen unto you. In verse 14, for we are made partakers of Christ. What's the next word? If. That's a condition. It's a conditional keeping. He keeps us in his grace, but then the condition is this: if we hold the beginning of our confidence steadfast unto the end. I pray we'll stand and stay until.
You have received the message from our pastor, Pastor W.F. Kumuyi, the General Superintendent of the Parallel Bible Church. It is my wish that as you listen, you accept the old word and you will let them sink into your heart. And by the grace of the Lord, you will never regret it. It is my prayer that by next week, when our pastor shall come up again to present another message, you will be there, your family will be there, and your friends. And I believe as you are listening to the message every week, by the grace of the Lord, you will never be the same. Let us pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, We thank you, O Lord, because of today's message. We thank you, O Lord, because of the one you let us listen to last week and the one we are going to listen to the next week. By the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, if you tarry, we shall listen together once again next week. And if not, every one of us will be there with you in the kingdom of God in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because you are the Lord that answers prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.